we're studying in an international house, so the building itself is a school for English for Argentinian students.
You get the feel of being an adult here. And I'm not gonna say you grow up fast, but you quickly realize things about yourself outside of a country than if you were in a country.
Set yourself free.
Being a black man in Argentina, it definitely is kind of different. I mean, I'm okay with being looked at. It's okay, it's fine with me. You know I'm black, I know I'm different. That's fine with me.
I grew up around black people, so there were certain things that were just like known. We didn't really speak about, but we just like rolled with it. So like coming here and having people like ask those questions, like what is it really like being black in America? And I'm like, oh, I've never really thought about it before because I live in a black environment.
I've even met like locals that have told me like I had a different opinion about black people before I met you. I couldn't understand why someone would openly like ponder their curiosity onto another person, like in their face, like to show like the curiosity within your face. Like it is 2023. I think that there can be some like personal responsibility to do your own research or formulate your own opinions outside of what's being fed to you.
For sure.
I love that.
I think I have been in a position where I've had to navigate myself within non-black spaces a lot or kind of often. So being here was a bit of the same. To me, it just reminds me that I have to be a little bit more adaptable than everyone else.
I dress different, I look different, my hair is different, my skin is different. I literally wear a tiara every day. Like, that's just who I am, and like, they're not used to it. And it's like, people will like approach me and like, they'll immediately like start trying to speak English to me because they automatically assume that I'm a foreigner. And I feel like because I am a foreigner and I look like a foreigner, I dress like a foreigner, I'm targeted a lot more too. So it's not even just necessarily my blackness, it's just the fact that I, like they know I'm not from here.
You guys are in school?
High school.
You guys know any things we can do around Buenos Aires?
Yeah, you can go a place that it calls Palermo Soho.
It's definitely been a great experience. I mean, just even walking around a big city. I don't live in a big city. I'm from St. Louis, Missouri. I mean, it's a place, but it's like, you know, everyone knows each other, so it's kind of closed in. But to live in a city like this, big in Argentina.
Just having conversations with other people and being able to navigate the space of we can learn together. Or even on your own, learning with someone else or learning by yourself and learning to not only navigate the city and like the different like bus system or like not being able to speak the language, but also navigating how to find your place in society.
Coming here and like studying history of art and like being in all of these natural environments and like being able to paint in the park, like my sketchbook is almost full with paintings and I'm so proud of myself because like I've really been on my art.
Honestly, this has been one of the best trips of my life. I'm not gonna lie. I mean, I know when I get back home, it's not gonna be as, you know, safe to just do a lot of the things that I'm doing here.
It is still very safe here. There hasn't been a moment that I haven't felt safe here. And so for me, when traveling as a black woman or traveling as a woman in general, I think it's super important to feel safe. And even walking alone at night, I feel safe.
The culture here is amazing. The city here is a great feeling. You know? Kane got the hammer in the
wrench. I pull up and I put a million dollars. Oh, I get it. They painted me out to be the bad guy. Well, it's the last time you want to see a bad guy do the rap game like me. I went and cut the chopsticks. Put it in my bun just to pop shit. I'm always in the top shit.
The main thing that Argentina has really taught me is just to love myself. I will always appreciate this country for that.